Why don't we organise the hospital ball? It'll be fun.
It'll be sorted out by this evening.
Did you try saying that like you meant it?
Morning.
Hey, got your mirror balls.
Never mind the balls, Ken. Where's the dance floor?
Oh, that's on its way over. My cousin's bringing it from third. It's all in hand.
That's what you said about the group.
Oh, I've saved your bacon there too. Oh,
don't tell me. It's your brother-in-law's uncle from Hull.
No.
There's got to be someone from your family.
What's wrong with my family?
There just seem to be an awful lot of them. And by some miracle, they put in the lowest tender for the bar, the catering, the dance floor, the marquee hire, and more or less anything else I can think of.
Ah, well, I'd work in Bunch, the Opkirks, you know, and this band's no relation.
Who are they?
Call the Upbeats, to sort of play on words.
Can they sort of play their instruments?
Of course they can. Well, if you call it playing. Always preferred something with a bit more of a tune, he said.
So how'd you get hold of them at such short notice?
The guitarist. He's Alan's brother.
So what about the drink?
Oh, it's a bit early in the day for me, love.
Where is it?
Oh, it's all taken care of, all right. I can't stand gassing all day.
Well, there's no need to pick on Ken. He's doing his best.
Who for? The ball or the Hopkirk family?
At least he found a group. Unlike the person that went to college with a very close friend of the manager of Procol Harum and was sure he could get them to play here.
All right. You've reminded me about that every day for the last month.
Staff nurse Taylor?
Coming, matron.
Oh, come on, Vic. I've got to get back to hospital for an operation at 10:30.
Your plastic surgery.
Oh, you're so funny.
Brothers, eh? Who'd have them?
I could do with mine giving us an hand with this gear.
All right, I'm coming.
Are you sure this kit works? It looks a bit knackered to me.
Yeah, it'll be fine.
Hey, listen, thanks for doing this. You didn't have to.
Go on, see it. Your big brother's a star.
Makes a change from saying my big brother's up to summit.
You've been taking the antibiotics?
Yeah, like you said.
Good. That also looks like it's starting to clear up. Now, I told you when I saw you before that it was unusual to have such a large mouth ulcer. I've had the results back, and, it's bad news, I'm afraid. You have syphilis. Do you understand what that means?
But I can't have...
Well, I'm sorry, but there's no doubt about it, I'm afraid. Now, luckily, it can be treated very effectively by the antibiotics that we gave you, but we also need to make sure that the person who you caught it from receives treatment. Was it your boyfriend?
I don't have a boyfriend. I can't tell you.
Well, then you have to tell him.
Ken! May I have a word with you?
What's the problem, Mr. M?
Dr. Cheriton and staff nurse Taylor may have been born yesterday, but I wasn't.
I don't quite get what you're driving at.
The red wine that you provided for the last hospital ball had been nowhere near a grape. In fact, it was rather more Burnley than Burgundy.
Aye, well, right proper mix-up that was.
Especially if you had the misfortune to drink it. I shall be watching what you plan to serve this evening with interest.
Ah, well, actually, I've got a brand new supplier.
Ken, there's still no dance floor.
Ah, well, that's because my cousin wanted to give it one last French polish.
Yes.
There's a call for you, Dad.
Oh, I'd better take that's probably him. Well, excuse me.
Never again. Running this ball's been one long nightmare.
You should try running a hospital.
We'll see you at the ball this evening, Mr. Sutton. Only 3 pairs of tickets left for tonight. Good, isn't it?
We'll see. Lizzie, did you put that poster there?
No, it was Dr. Cheriton, so people could see it when they came in.
We have notice boards for that.
Lizzie, just going to get something from the car. Be 2 minutes.
Still waging your one-woman campaign against the ball?
It's caused nothing but trouble. I warned you this would happen if you handed it over to 2 junior members of staff.
Well, when it came to booking disc jockeys and pop groups, I thought that they would be more in touch with current tastes. I'm afraid I still think of Henry Hall as being rather avant-garde. La, 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 la. I can't believe what you say, 'cause I can see what you do. La, 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 la.
what you say, cause I can see what you do. When she gets me in the door, then she says I'm a man. But when we walk down the street, she never holds my hand. She said one day that she will marry me, but she tells
Missy, there was a tall man in a suit. He was here a few minutes ago.
Mr. Sutton, he was buying tickets for the ball.
Oh, right, so he's a patient here, is he?
Yeah, Dr. Omerod.
Okay, thanks.
I'm 5 miles away from flaming Aidan's field, and the flaming radiator that you said you'd flaming fixed is leaking buckets!
Well, what do you expect me to do?
Well, you could start by telling Mr. Rose I'll be late for theatre. Why shouldn't I panic? This is an emergency!
I think he got the message. He'll sort some out for us.
Well, there's no rush. We're happy here.
Yeah.
Casey picked these. She asked me to bring them in.
They're lovely. The children understand, do they?
I'd be surprised. I've made a rotten job of telling them.
You haven't had the test results yet?
This afternoon. The neurologist is coming over from Leeds. Then I suppose I really might have some explaining to do. You see, Kate has decided that her mummy is going to get better.
She might. I mean, I have seen cases.
I know. I keep telling myself that all this uncertainty is the worst part. Being in limbo. But then I think perhaps that's better than knowing for certain.
Oh, it's ever so glamorous, this being a pop star, isn't it?
Anyone comes will let you know.
Well, you're dead if you don't.
So, you and Gina, going all right, that is?
Gosh, a great lass. Hey, don't forget to wash your hands.
Shut up!
I've got some news. Since last week, I'm a professional musician, union card the lot.
Brilliant. When do we get to see you?
Ah, you don't. It's on a ship, around the world cruise. The thing is, I haven't told Gina I'm going to. But that's why I want to do the gig tonight. You know, give us a chance to do one last show together.
Before you dump her?
Hey, it's not like that.
That's what it sounds like to me. How long are you going for?
10 months, maybe a year. And I'm going to tell her tonight, so just don't let on, okay?
Hop in.
What's going on?
Well, you said it were an emergency, didn't you? Anyway, I do with getting out of the hospital for a bit.
So where's toolkit?
Well, I don't need it. I've got this. Well, off you go, I'll sort this out. And hey, Alan, anyone asks you, you haven't seen me, all right? Hey up, Vic.
Yeah, need a hand?
Aye, pour some water in. Now that'll pump the hole till we can get it to a garage. And look at that, plenty of shell left over foot tank.
Is this my peptic ulcer?
Yes, Ian Lake. He moved up here fairly recently. He presented with epigastric pain and anemia.
Have I seen x-rays?
Well, they didn't show up much either way. Any more hematemesis, sister?
No, doctor.
You don't dare vomit blood, not on Sister Bridget's ward. Good morning. I'm Mr. Rose, and you are lucky enough to have me as your surgeon. I do about 100 of these jobs every year, and by and large, there's no problem at all. I'll just dig around in your gut and straighten things out.
I was asking Dr. Ormerod about whether you'll avert the vagus nerves.
Mr. Lake has been reading up on his condition.
Oh, dear. And what line of work are you in, Mr. Lake?
I'm a bookkeeper.
So I could tell you that I was going to plait your vagus nerves around your duodenum, and you wouldn't have the faintest idea whether to believe me or not.
No.
I suggest you let me worry about your vagus nerves. And I promise I won't give you any advice on how to keep your books.
That's quite sore, isn't it?
Yes, doctor.
I've been telling her for weeks she needed to come and see a doctor.
All right, you can get up now.
I didn't want to make a fuss.
Well, somebody had to make a fuss. She's hardly eaten a thing for days. And when she does, she doesn't keep it down.
He's more worried about it than I am. I don't much want to eat. I just feel full up all the time.
Have you had any difficulty swallowing?
A bit.
I'd like to get some x-rays done, just to be on the safe side. And then I want to ask one of my colleagues to take a look at you.
Thank you, doctor.
I'll be right back.
questions for you.
I really can't.
Yes, you can. Lizzie's friend's going to babysit and you and I are going to the ball. There's absolutely no reason why you should be the only one in the hospital not to.
Oh, why not? Thank you very much.
Oh, Gordon, Philip Sutton. One of your patients, isn't he?
Mm-hmm, yes. Him, his wife and his children, why?
Oh, it's probably nothing. What's he like?
Well, he's got a factory out on the York Road. Does a lot for the Rotary. Raises a lot of money for the hospital.
You're not treating him for anything at the moment, are you?
No. In fact, I can't remember him ever really being ill. His wife's pregnant, though. I'm seeing her.
Right, thank you. That's useful to know.
There's something going on here that Dr. Cheriton and I aren't very happy about. We think it would be best to do a small exploratory operation so that we can see what's happening.
When would you do that?
No time like the present. I could rearrange my list for this morning and do it right now.
I don't know that I want to.
I would strongly advise it.
You'll only worry if you have to wait.
I can see you're all ganging up on me. And you won't give me a minute's peace fussing over me if we go back home. All right.
Well done. Would you let Dr. Ormerod know that I might not get to his peptic ulcer this morning?
Right here.
There's been a slight hitch, I'm afraid, Ian. You're going to have to delay your operation till later in the week. We've had an emergency admission, and Mr. Rose doesn't think he'll be able to fit you in today.
Who's in charge here?
Of the hospital.
I want to see him. This is complete incompetence.
Well, Mr. Middleditch is the hospital secretary, but this is a clinical decision. He won't overrule it.
I want to talk to him. Now.
Uh-huh. Well, I'll see what I can do. Mr. Lake.
I know. Leave him to me.
All ready? I suppose so. Off you go. You can't come with me.
I'll be right outside.
I know.
I'm going to give you an injection, Mary. Then I want you to count backwards from 10. Okay.
10, 9, 8, 7.
They never asked what was wrong, did you notice?
We don't know. Not for certain.
Mary was telling me they'd been married 40 years. The only time they've ever spent a night apart was when George was in the army.
And they're obviously devoted to one another.
They probably never tried organising a hospital ball together.
Doctor, there's a man in reception with 200 potted shrimps.
Doesn't sound fatal. He can wait.
Oh, no, we can't. He says they need to go in a fridge. And you know how shrimps can get.
I don't see what this has got to do with me.
Well, it's for the ball.
No, we're having prawn cocktails.
No. Ken got this deal on shrimps, so I said to change it.
Find your father. He's in charge of the catering.
Do you have a patient for me, or am I supposed to make my own entertainment this morning?
The Royal. Okie dokie.
Why is my office full of seafood?
It's all a bit complicated.
Well, in that case, I probably don't want to know, but I would like to speak to your father. Would you be kind enough to ask him to come and see me?
How can I help?
I have a patient in Milner Ward, Ian Lake. He was due to have a peptic ulcer operation today, but we had to cancel, and he reacted very badly.
That's not unusual, is it?
Well, I can understand he was disappointed and angry, but there was more to it than that. Well, maybe I'm just being too oversensitive, I don't know.
Well, how did you find the patient before this morning?
Well, it was very intense. Obviously very intelligent. He seems to know more about his condition than I do. He was very calm and objective about the whole thing until I told him that the operation was cancelled.
I'll try and take a look at him later.
Thank you.
Your diagnosis was spot on. There's the tumour. At least that's the primary site. It's spread all over the shop.
Are you going to remove it?
No, too far gone for that. Oh, well, it was worth a try. Catgut sutures, please stop us. And I hope you'll save a dance for me this evening.
Are you coming?
Wouldn't miss it for the world. Say what you like about Middleditch. He certainly knows how to throw a party.
Mr. Middleditch isn't in charge.
Who is?
Me and staff nurse Taylor.
Oh, too late now. I've bought my ticket.
My brother's group's going to be playing.
And you really think that makes it any better?
Oh, hey, be careful. Give me that ale, I'll take that.
Come on, pretty baby, let's all move it and groove it.
Could I have another word with you about Philip Sutton?
Mm-hmm. If you tell me what it's all about.
I've got a 20-year-old patient with syphilis. And she's not being very helpful as far as tracing contacts is concerned. But she works for Sutton. And I saw him meet her in the car park. And to me, they looked like they were more than just good friends.
Well, I don't think Sutton's like that. He's happily married.
Oh, and as we all know, men who appear to be happily married don't have affairs, do they?
Fair point. Let's just say I'd be surprised.
It's just a hunch, that's all.
Female intuition.
What, are you saying you don't work on intuition once in a while? It's all strictly scientific, is it?
Oh, I'd like a little more to go on than that. Anyway, even if it is Sutton, it's up to your patient whether she tells him or not.
What about his wife and her unborn child? He could have infected both of them.
If your patient doesn't want to help, Jill, there's not a lot you can do.
Hmm. We'll see.
I'll break the news to Mrs. Dooley as soon as she's got over the anaesthetic.
She really doesn't need to know about the cancer.
I can't lie to her.
Don't be so naive. Of course you can. I've been dealing with cases like this for well over 20 years, and I can assure you that at times like this, ignorance is truly bliss.
I don't feel very comfortable misleading her.
Well, that is a shame. You don't think, perhaps, that your patient's comfort and peace of mind is rather more important than your own? You've time to get over it. She doesn't. Right. Let's deal with hubby. Does he know how serious his wife's condition is?
He had a fair idea.
Mm-hmm. Shouldn't be a problem then, provided we handle him with sensitivity.
How is she?
I'm sorry, old chap. I'm afraid it's bad news. Do please sit down. Mary has stomach cancer. I had hoped to be able to remove it, but the disease has spread to her peritoneum. All we can hope to do at this stage is to try and make her as comfortable as possible.
I knew it had to be something like that. There's nothing you can do?
Not at this stage, no.
How long? I mean, how long have we got?
It's always difficult to say in a case like this, but it's probably weeks rather than months. Possibly even less than that. If you'll agree, we won't tell Mary this.
No, there's no need for her to know. I've been trying to keep her spirits up, you know. Can I see her?
We'll be moving her over to a ward. You can come and sit with her then.
Thank you, Doctor.
Hello, I'm Dr. Klein. Dr. Ormerod asked me to have a word with you. How are you feeling?
Dr. Ormerod knows how I'm feeling. It's all in my notes. I need this operation.
Yeah, I'm here to see if we can sort something out. You've had your appendix removed recently.
It's a couple of years ago.
And another operation for a kidney stone. You've been very unlucky with your health for someone of your age.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, a third operation for a man of your age is slightly unusual. So I was just trying to establish if there was something in your medical history that we missed.
You're not my doctor or the surgeon. Who are you?
I'm a psychiatrist.
I see. Well, I find that very insulting. That you even think that I want to see the hospital secretary. I want to see him now.
I'll try and find him, but if we can talk a little more...
I can get this hospital closed down. Do you know that?
I'll get Mr. Middleditch. We could have a problem here.
Hey, do you want me to do that?
No.
Leave it to professionals.
How's it going?
They're just trying to fix the speakers.
So they haven't started to rehearse yet?
Not as such, no.
Doctor, my Uncle Michael wants to know what to do with the dance floor.
The traditional arrangement is to put it on the ground for people to dance on.
The thing is, he can't get it in the marquee. The door's too small. And he wants to know what to do.
This is turning into a really perfect day.
I appreciate you coming to see me, Mr. Middleditch.
Have you heard of Munchausen syndrome?
No, I haven't.
It's pretty rare. Basically, it's when a patient fakes the symptoms of a disease.
So, you think he's malingering?
No, malingering is usually for a particular reason. To get off work or to make an insurance claim. This is more a form of attention-seeking. As you said, he talks about his illness in a very objective way. Maybe that's because he doesn't have it. He's just read about it in medical journals.
But he's showing physical symptoms. He's vomiting blood.
Are you sure it's blood? There have been cases where patients have simulated that with coffee grounds or tomato ketchup.
So what do you suggest we do?
Oh, he's had other operations. I'd like to find out where he had them and whether they were necessary. I think we should keep an eye on him.
Well, he seems to be a little happier. But an apology wouldn't do any harm.
Well, I'm not at all sure that we have anything we need to apologise for.
No, probably not. But it might make life easier all round.
Hey, there's about 15 different people looking for you.
Let them.
This isn't like you.
Alan, I've been working night and day to get that ball ready. And you know what's happened? Mr. Middleditch has only gone and sent back the booze I ordered.
Why did he do that?
Well, according to Lizzie, he said it wasn't good enough. What's the point of serving good stuff? I mean, after a few bevvies, no one's going to be bothered. And half of it's only going to end up in the flower beds anyway. So officially, no one's told me, so they can sort it out themselves.
But you can't have a party without drink.
Alan, lad, it's not my problem.
Mr. Rose had a look, and as we thought, there is a bit of an obstruction in your stomach. But we think we can let nature take its course. We don't need to do anything more at the moment. And we can certainly give you something to reduce the discomfort and stop you feeling so sick.
I told you this was a lot of fuss about nothing.
You know me.
You need to get some rest for now. We'll come back and see you later.
Thank you.
Since before lunch, where have you been?
There was a problem with the dance floor. I had to carry each section individually into the marquee. Then I had to try and find out why the drink hasn't arrived.
You should have asked me to help.
You weren't there, and it was a lot easier to do by myself.
If I've done something wrong, I'd like to know what it is.
We were supposed to be running this ball together.
Well, we would be if you ever bothered talking to me.
You're never there.
No, I've been rushed off my feet. And if anyone's got a question about the ball, they always come to you. They think you're in charge because you're the doctor.
Well, it's lucky for you that they do. Because when the whole thing turns out to be an unmitigated disaster, it's going to be me who looks a complete idiot.
It's not that bad.
Oh, it is. The food isn't ready. The group's equipment doesn't work. There's no sign of any drink. Ken Hopkirk has disappeared off the face of the earth. And I could have done with some help from you.
Well, I could have done without you treating me like some sort of lackey. Have you any idea how arrogant and obnoxious you've been these last few days?
Perhaps if we didn't see quite so much of each other, it wouldn't be such a problem.
Well, if that's what you want, fine.
Hello, Paula. I'm sorry to bother you at work. I should have given you these forms. You need to give them to whoever you might have had sexual contact with recently. They contain information about treatment they can receive. They can come to the hospital or special clinic in Leeds, whatever they prefer.
I'll do that.
Have you managed to speak to whoever might have infected you?
No. This is really embarrassing, you know. Anyone could hear us.
Right, well, if this man is married, then his wife is likely to be infected. And if she's pregnant, then the baby could be at real risk too.
Please, can you go?
Good afternoon.
Hello. I'm sorry to have interrupted your work. Doctor, it's Ian Lake. I can't find him anywhere.
Well, could he have discharged himself?
He hasn't taken his clothes or any of his things.
Well, he must be somewhere.
Could the patient have collapsed somewhere?
It's not very likely. I'm more concerned about his mental condition.
I see. We'd better find him then.
George went to get a cup of tea. I finally persuaded him. He can be so obstinate. I don't know why he has to sit with me all the time.
He's worried about you.
I'm worried about me. I know what you're doing, but you don't have to. My mother died of stomach cancer. I know it's not very nice to talk about, but there's no point you all walking on eggshells. That's what I've got, isn't it?
Yes.
Does George know that too?
Yes, we told him.
Don't let on that you told me. He'll only worry if he thinks I know, won't he?
Doctor, quick!
What in heaven's name are you doing, man?
Get away from me.
Find Mr. Rose. Well, this is all a bit of a mess, isn't it? We could do with some help from casualty. Don't you think?
Put that on the table.
What's Vic up to?
How do you mean?
I know what he's like. There's something going on.
Well, he wouldn't tell me.
Yeah, he would. He's a big show-off and he thinks you're his number one fan.
He hasn't said.
Well, promise me something. If he's going to do something stupid like ask me to marry him on stage tonight, then tell me. I'm not ready for that and I don't want to end up looking silly.
Like I said, he hasn't told me. But if he does...
Thanks, Alan.
You've got enough trays?
Didn't do a bad job for a beginner. Think we should look at that ulcer while we've got him here?
I don't think that he has an ulcer. He faked the symptoms.
It's a shame he decided to do my job instead of yours. Trust you called the men in the white coats. Cut.
Dr. Klein is transferring him to a psychiatric hospital as soon as he's fit to travel.
Could you ask her to be quite clear in the notes that I did not make this incision? I do have my reputation to consider.
You've got to tell Gina about this job.
I'm going to after gig. Got all worked out in my head.
Play better than we ever have before and then quit while we're on top. Then I'll get a bottle of shampoo and let her down gently.
You really fancy yourself, don't you?
Not half as much as Gina does.
Yeah. Then you better be careful what you say.
Okay, I get the message. I'm going to tell her, but I'll do it with a bit of style. All right.
Where's the wine, Ken?
Mr. Middleditch sent it back, and the beer with it.
So what are we going to do?
Well, if I was in charge, I'd start panicking.
Doctor?
Sorry. Did you want something?
Are you feeling all right?
Not really, no. I've just had Caroline's test results. She's not going to get any better.
I'm sorry.
Obviously, sooner or later, I'll have to decide how long.
There's no rush, is there?
Not really, no. The machine can keep her alive for years, probably.
If you ever need to talk, you know I'm always here day and night.
Thank you.
It can be hard having no one to talk to when you need it most. I do know that.
Why did you send back the drink?
I thought it was advisable.
I know your matron think I'm doing this all wrong, but even she hasn't tried to sabotage the evening. What are the guests going to drink?
I think this will suffice.
Where did that come from?
I have a nephew who owns an off-license.
Oh, what is it?
Why did you have to do it? You know you've got me the sack.
Why?
Philip, Mr. Sutton, he wanted to know what you were doing there, and I had to tell him. He said it were all my fault.
Had you been having sex with him, Paula?
I love him.
Have you been with anybody else?
No, nobody, not at all.
So you were infected by Sutton. He must have caught it from somebody else, and he could still be spreading it. He needs treatment.
I wish I'd never told you. Never come here at all.
You'd be very ill by now.
But I'd still have me job. And I'd still have him. Are you ready for this? Ta-da!
That is fantastic. Look at you.
What are you hiding?
You'll have to wait and see.
Wonderful.
So do you. What a beautiful dress.
Thank you. You've done a fantastic job organising this evening, you know.
Just hope it's worth it.
Of course it is. Aidan, you look absolutely wonderful.
Thanks.
Come on, you've done all the hard work. Time to enjoy yourself.
Good evening, everybody. And welcome to the Royal Grand Charity Ball. Now, first of all, let me introduce you to your dance band for this evening, the Upbeats. Now, the Royal has something of a reputation to keep up on these occasions.
One, two, three, four.
Do you want to dance?
Give it here, man. Is your choice of wine?
No, handpicked by Mr. Middleditch.
In that case, there shouldn't be a problem. Rather a precocious little vintage.
From Mr. Middleditch's nephew, this lot.
Devil.
I hope the music's not keeping you awake.
No, George and me, we used to love dancing.
Me too.
We could nip down there for a quick foxtrot.
Maybe not tonight. When I get better.
Aye, when you get better.
Well, I think my nephew Martin's done us proud, don't you?
Well, I've had no complaints.
Well, at least it's not made out of rhubarb, like the plonk you were going to inflict on us again. Have you tried it?
No. Well, I'll stick to brown ale, if you don't mind. Cheers.
You don't know what you're missing.
Oh, Dad, this is disgusting.
I know.
Where did it come from?
Mr. Middleditch's nephew.
Why are you serving it?
Well, what Mr. Middleditch don't know is it's the same stuff that I had earlier. His nephew supplies me as well. All he's done is change the label on it. He's charged his uncle two bob a bottle more. Mr. Middleditch thinks he's got a bargain. Cheers.
What's wrong?
Sorry, Jill. I can't.
Oh, Gordon, you're entitled to a night off.
It just doesn't work that way for me. Look, Caroline's never going to get any better, and I'm just here dancing. For all I know, she can hear the music up in her room. Look, forgive me. I just can't do this.
Do you want to go?
I'm sorry. Stay. Enjoy yourself.
Okay. Well, actually, it's not okay, but it is pretty much what I expected.
You all right?
Wouldn't mind someone to dance with.
He'll be over.
I wouldn't count on it. And I really don't care.
More brandy, my dear?
No, thank you, I won't.
No. Well, in that case.
Thank you very much. We're going to do a slow number for you called Dream.
We must dance.
So you didn't bring a torch?
Large number of young nurses and a great many dark corners. Not in my experience, a good combination.
I always thought it worked rather well.
It's not only the nurses that need watching.
Oh, dear. It happens every time.
Hello, Doctor.
It's going all right, isn't it?
No complaints so far.
Do you still dance with nurses?
Well, I suppose I could be persuaded.
Excuse me. Come and have a drink with us, David. I'd like you to meet some of the governors.
Please. In private.
I don't think this is really the time.
Well, we can talk here if you like.
Won't be my love. It's about the charity collection.
Why did you sack Paula Brody?
I beg your pardon?
You heard me.
Well, not that it's any of your business, but I found it to be rather unreliable.
Right. And how reliable are you, Mr. Sutton? Do you know how dangerous syphilis is?
Yes. And I thought a doctor had a duty of confidentiality to her patients.
Not talking about my patients, I'm talking about you. You're being treated for it?
Of course I am. As soon as I found out.
You told your wife?
This is absolutely none of your business.
Right, well, if you haven't, then maybe I should.
Look, I don't know what Paula said, but she was lying. We've never even had sex.
Well, it's a disease that's spread by direct contact, so it's fairly clear what you did. I don't know, maybe we should speak to Janet, see if she thinks that constitutes sex or not.
I could have you struck off for behaving like this.
Well, if you want publicity, go ahead.
What do you want?
Two things. Make sure your wife sees Dr. Allmore up tomorrow. And find another job for Paula. Enjoy your evening.
Enjoying yourself?
Just starting to, Lizzie, yeah. Thank you.
What was all that when you were dancing with Mr. Rose?
Put it this way. It was a question of, was that his pipe in his pocket, or was he just pleased to see me? And his pipe was definitely on the table.
Stay forever, I will understand. Believe me.
It's off. Okay, it's clear. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Look, keep back, everybody, please. Give the doctor room.
He's arrested.
Is it going to be all right? Let the doctor do his work.
Got a pulse.
Right, let's get him to casualty.
Sister. Something's not right.
Pulse is 80 in regular. Blood pressure's 120 over 80.
Good.
Oh, do you want to do anything about the burns on his hands?
Let's get them covered with a sterile dressing. We'll worry about that later.
How's he doing?
Should be okay. If you have to electrocute yourself, a tent full of doctors is probably a pretty good place to do it.
How is he?
He'll be okay. You know what he's like.
I thought he was gonna die, you know. I really did. And I was thinking, typical Vic, using the cheapest gear he could get. That's not how you're supposed to feel, is it? Does that sound stupid?
No, it's about right.
I'll tell you something, though. He's a great guitarist. We played a storm tonight. The group's really starting to go somewhere. Right then. Suppose we better pack his gear up.
I'll go and tell him.
I like you a lot better when you're doing your day job.
That's a good thing. So I'm giving up organising balls after tonight.
Me too.
Look. I'm sorry about the way I've behaved the last few weeks. But what you said earlier, have I really been that bad?
You've had your moments. But so have I. Things haven't been much fun for either of us.
When I said we shouldn't see so much of each other, I didn't mean that. But being with each other at work and outside, there's no hiding place, is there? You really do get to see me at my worst.
And your best. Once in a while.
So maybe we can go on seeing each other?
It's pretty hard to avoid.
You're dancing?
You asking?
Know anywhere we can go?
I've heard there's a bit of a do on.
Dr. Cherishin!
How's the ball going?
It's had its moment. You should have stayed.
I've just been thinking of all the things that Caroline and I didn't talk about. The main one being that our marriage wasn't working. Well, at least she got around to trying to do something about it. She knew she had to move on. And that's what I've got to do. Be brave enough to take the next step. It's not too late for a drink, is it?
No.
I jumped out of my skin when I saw you go over like that.
No.
Tell us about your new job, then. Oh, you're a lion toad, Vic Morris. So just how big are you going to make it as a ship's cook, then?
You told me you were in band.
I'm going to work my way up.
We'll take all the time you need. Because me and you were finished. The group's got a new guitarist.
See? What to do to deserve that?
Told one lie too many. And you can forget about the cruise. With your hands in that state, you might never peel spuds again.
Something in the way he moves.
I'm sorry about the noise.
I like it. Have you two been dancing the night away?
We haven't really had the chance.
You should grab it with both hands while you can.
Mary and me, we both love dancing. We've been to the Tower Ballroom Blackpool every year for I don't know how long. We'll be back again this summer.
No, George.
Of course we will. You're going to get better, isn't she, Doctor?
No, she isn't. We won't be going to any more dances. That's just how it is. I'd love to have seen you two dance.
Well, there's nothing stopping them.
I suppose there isn't. May I?
Why not?
Royals back in the new year and Heartbeat returns next Sunday.
A gang of teenagers were racing round on their motorbikes.
I gave you some speed to flog. Where's the money? I didn't ask for them pills and I'm not selling them, are I?
I found these in his drawer. He said he got them from you.
I certainly didn't prescribe these.
They supply shovels to the gentry.
I told you there are no drugs here.
Well, I'll make sure in future that there aren't, Mrs. Fletcher.
What made you think there were, anyway?
I wouldn't divulge names. So he knew you were out and used me to get them.
I can't believe it.
I've lost two patients, damaged my reputation and people's trust in me.
He never said anything about a drugs raid. He just asked for the list.
I told you it was part of an important inquiry, which it was.
You didn't tell me that she'd already refused to help you.
Well, he drove off in the Bentley.
What, he drove off in my Bentley? But why didn't you stop him?
It is his job.